Well, hello there and welcome to our very first edition of the Audi MedCup TV for the 2011 season. This is such an exciting season. We've got so many new things happening this year. And we've got here joining me in the studio today, Nacho Postigo, the man that started everything off for the Audi MedCup. Thank you so much for joining us. And a man who's been so successful out there on day one of the circuit this year, Marcus Visser. He is the helmsman and skipper of the boat that is leading the leaderboard overnight after two races. As I mentioned before, there is so much to look forward to this season. We've got new boats on board, we've got new skippers, new sailors, and we're going to have a look at the highlights of last season and what there is to look forward to this season.
The Audi Med Cup is back for the seventh successive season. Each year it's grown bigger and better, and this year will be no exception. Since its inception into the World Sailing Calendar in 2005, it's become the world's leading regatta circuit. Set in five spectacular locations on the Mediterranean and the Atlantic, the tour kicks off in Cascais, Portugal, then travels to Marseille in France, Cagliari in Sardinia, Cartagena in Spain, before wrapping up the season in Barcelona in September. Eight lightning-fast monohulls exhibiting the latest in high-tech boat construction attract some of the biggest names in world sailing. Olympic gold medalists, America's Cup legends, world champions, they're all here. A new feature this year is the incorporation of a new class. The Soto 40 is a one design boat. And here, with all the boats the same, it is purely the skill of the crew and onboard tactics that will help prevail. It's no wonder the Audi Med Cup circuit has become known the world over as the Champions League of Sailing.
Well, as it mentioned there, we are here in Cascais, and it might look a little bit murky behind us, but we have had a great day of racing to get the things to get the regatta kicked off. And I first want to go to Marcus, because you have had quite an incredible day out there, considering you're on a new team, you're new to the Audi Med Cup, new to TP52s. What was the secret to being so successful on day one?
I mean, first of all, our owner Udo Schütz gave me the chance to choose my crew, whom I want to sail with. And we are a really strong team in the boat. So I think that's one of the main factors we are sailing so well already from the first day on, because aero position is very strong, and Hamish Pepper's calling tactics, we have a good bowman, we have good grinders, good pitmen. I think the whole setup is working very well for us, and that's the first outcome looks really promising for us.
Nacho, you've really set these guys up, because you've put them in some new boats this year. Nacho is the technical director of the Audi Med Cup. So, you know, you've got all these new rules and everything, and it's made it really competitive. And out there on day one today, we had some interesting conditions. How do you think they cope with it in their new boats?
I think it was going to be a kind of, okay, today is the opening, today is where we're going to see things. And I have to say, it's been a lot of talking about the boats that did some pre-regattas before the Med Cup, and Quantum and Azzurra, Ran, they were racing together. And there was not much said about Container or Synergy, so it was everyone was expecting what Quantum is doing and what is Run doing, and suddenly out of the blue came Container. they were just launching the boat here the first day, and off we go.
Well, as we mentioned, Container did do a very great race. They had two great races, in fact, today, and made up a lot of places. So we're going to take a look at the highlights of race one.
Race 1 started with 14 to 15 knots of wind, and Synergy led the way from the pin end of the line, showing great confidence with their brand new boat. They tacked early and managed to get right across the whole fleet to the right-hand side of the course and start to open up a comfortable lead. They sailed with confidence down the first run, extending all the way down, in spite of some threats from some other boats. The Russian team's boat is brand new, has only been sailing for a few weeks, but the Russian crew has been sailing for a long time. On the last run, Quantum made a mistake, having been second all the way around the course by not watching the all-new container. And while Synergy sailed comfortably across the line in first place, Quantum let go their strong second position, allowing Container to catch some wind and move forwards to a dominating second place. The critical moment was halfway down the second run. Container, far out on the left of the run, managed to catch a lot more wind, sail faster and sail around the outside of Quantum and sneak into a nice second place.
After race one, Synergy on top there and Container coming in second place. Marcus, if I could just come back to you again. We've got Quantum Racing in third place there. You did have a bit of a battle going on with them today. We'll have a look at race two in a moment. But how was that battle? Was it? Do you think there's going to be a lot of closely fought races on tour this year?
Yeah, I mean, all boats on the race course so far are really even. We have a little edge downwind, so we are really fast downwind. So we rolled Quantum, the second downwind in the first race. And then they had to jibe, we jibed behind them, and we were still going faster. So we just passed them by boat speed. The same happened on the second race, in the second downwind. So we were just going a little bit quicker than them. So downwind, we are quite fast, but upwind, all the boats are quite similar. And even, I think Azzurra is quite fast upwind, but how you come out of the starting box is decisive for the whole race. So if you're in front, can sail your own race, have clear air, you can choose what you want. If you're just a little bit back of the fleet, even we are just 7 or 8 boats, all the ways are locked and you can't act anymore, you just can react. And so it's very, very important how you get out and how you sail the first crossing.
Yeah, absolutely. Nacho, you've been involved with the Med Cup for 7 years now. Can you tell us how important it is to get those first couple of races underway and get the consistency going for the team confidence?
It is very, very important, especially when you are having a brand new boat, like is the case of most of the teams in the TP52, is so much to learn and so many assumptions that you have made that maybe suddenly you come here and, oh, I thought we were quick downwind. And suddenly you find out that someone else is much quicker than you downwind, which was the case today with Quantum and them. So it's, at the end of the day, you scratch your head and you say, okay, how can we improve this for tomorrow? How can we improve this for the rest of the season? And it's these first days, these first two races are like a shocker for the season. And it's
absolutely. And the Russian team Synergy was the boat that was ahead in race after race one on the leaderboard. Let's take a look at the race two highlights.
The start saw Brebon trying to start at the committee boat over early and compromise very quickly. The rest of the fleet headed out on starboard tack, but once again, thoughts were of the right-hand side of the course. Synergy started beautifully at the pin, showing good speed and confidence, but right beside her this time was Container with perhaps a stronger start than the first race. The first beat saw Synergy dominant again, but the right-hand side of the course started to look stronger and Quantum started to move ahead. On the first run, Azzurra left the pack and went out again to find her own breeze on the other side of the course and managed to sail around the front of the entire fleet at 3 or 4 knots faster than everybody else in a stronger stretch of breeze. As the fleet approached the leeward gate, a lot of big decisions had to be made. Perhaps a little bit of indecision on Synergy, and they had a few boat handling errors at the leeward mark, which allowed Container to come inside them and dominate up the bottom of the second beat. Synergy had problems with their spinnaker, didn't manage to trim their sails on quickly enough, and dropped 2 or 3 places straight away. As the boat sailed down the last leg, it was very clear that Audi Azzurra had a very, very big lead and was a runaway winner of that race. But there was a big fight going on for second place. And halfway down the run, Container and Quantum went their separate ways. Audi Azzurra, with a runaway lead, won the race quite comfortably, making a first win for this brand new boat. A few minutes of congratulations on board for a well-won race. But here was the big play for second place. Quantum went out to try and find Container again, but Container showed excessive speed and sailed around the outside and came through again to sneak past and get second place. The view from Quantum showed Container sailing away. So Container, the second win, the second place of the day, puts him overall leader after two races.
The leaderboard is looking after the first two races of the day. Container leading the way on 4 points overnight, followed by Audi Azzurra team and Quantum Racing in third. Now we can see the difference that a consistent day makes over not such a consistent day. I mean, Synergy won that first race and then finished sixth in the second race and then finished fourth overall. And Container didn't even win a race today. It was two second places and ended up on top. So all in all, I guess we can say a really great race, for a really great day for the TP52s today. And of course, tomorrow we get started on the Soto 40 series as well. Nacho, you're the expert on this. Can you talk us through a little bit? What can viewers expect from the Soto 40 series?
Well, today we have had our practice race, which has been, in fact, the first time that the whole fleet has been together. And what we have found is that it's even more close than, I would say, than with the TP52s, because the speed is almost identical across the boats. And it's only the teams and it's only the crew work and the tactics making the difference, and it's really, really close. So you will see that they are very familiar in looking to the 52s, and also the way we have to sail them is very, very, very similar. Consistency, as Marcus, is the key.
Absolutely. So murky conditions out there today. What can we expect for the rest of the week? Is it going to brighten up for us?
Yeah, tomorrow is looking a little bit more like south of Europe, and we will get some more clearer skies, but still will be some risk of showers, and the wind still not ideally as it should be here. And then as the weekend comes, we will see the north wind establishing and getting stronger and sunny skies. So I think we will have a very good end of the week. Friday, Saturday, Sunday will be spectacular as usual in Cascais.
Okay, and Marcus, a lot of pressure on you now. Do you feel the pressure, or are you just going to take this day by day?
No, I'm too old to feel the pressure. So we just go out and enjoy sailing, and it's fun sailing with this boat. So I sailed last couple of years RC44, which is a smaller boat, but also very fast and cool boat to sail. But the Met Cup and the 52 is a really nice circuit, so I think we made the right choice to move from in the Minimax into the 52 class. So as Nacho says, consistency is important, and all comes down to the teamwork. And I think we were so consistent today because we have a really good teamwork, as I said before, and that's very important.
The level of competition out there, what's your take on that? I mean, we've got some really impressive skippers out there. I mean, sailors in general out there, Olympic champions, world champions, America's Cup legends. Tell us about that.
I mean, the level is so equal outside. The boats are very, very well equal leveled. So you can have a good day and you can have a bad day. So it's just how you get out of the box, if you do one mistake, you will be penalized. Yes, immediately, yeah, because the level is so high and you have to stay out of trouble. You have to do your own race, try not to foul another boat, get a penalty turn to do, and then looks good.
Okay, well, best of luck for racing tomorrow, and you too, Nacho, in the brand new Soto 40 series. Thank you so much for joining us for the very first day of Audi Med Cup TV 2011. Do hope you join us back here tomorrow for hopefully some more exciting racing and some better conditions out there today. Hopefully we see the sunshine. We'll see you tomorrow.